All right, so let's get right into this match between the University of Waterloo and the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, abbreviated ASCHB. So we got a couple of bands already here from the teams. We've got the Nature's Prophet and the Bounty Hunter band out by Waterloo, and the OD and Earth Spirit will be banned out by the Hoop Ballers. Gotta say that they're probably gonna have a pretty hype team. And they've Radiant already made it into the second round of the event. So the college boys are gonna pick up the Beastmaster first. And while the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers Dire immediately team. Follow up with the Lone Druid and Enchantress combo. So they're going to pretty much dominate these lanes. Do pretty well there. University of Waterloo gonna pick up Dire the Lion. So let's just break this down a little bit. The Beastmaster and the Lion, loss of control there. You have the Primal Roar, which we saw in the last match was pretty good and made things very difficult for basically anybody you went on. And when comboed with the Lion, you have a lot of control right there. So that's pretty much just taking one hero off of the map at least. And with the Enchantress on the other team, the big burst damage is going to make it very easy for them to take her out. So she's going to have to try to build some kind of tanky items or really just stay out of the fights and hope that they don't just go on her. Should probably change the title. Alright, so we have a couple of bands coming out here more. It is the Viper and the Orsa that are going to get banned out. Viper, pretty annoying here to deal with, especially in the mid lane. Very difficult to shut him down early. Remaining. Although sometimes with good rotations, teams are able to do just that. Remaining. They will also ban out the Templar Assassins, so they're really focusing on the mids here for their bans. And maybe they have their mind on a certain mid. The Puck is going to get banned out by the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. So that's also a lot of control that Waterloo would have had. And the Orsa would have probably helped control the heroes a little bit more. And also the Orsa doesn't worry about the Enchantress untouchable at all. He just goes right through that. So the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers will pick up the Witch Doctor, which can disrupt the lineup of Waterloo a little bit. You throw out that coconut and hope that it bounces and creates a lot of havoc. And then, in terms of the Death Ward, there's a lot of stuff that Waterloo has to cancel that.
5 seconds remaining.
So you are going to have to be very careful with how you use it.
Reserve time.
And also your positioning when you do use it. Waterloo adds to their burst damage with the Zeus. And we don't see a mid yet for the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. So that may be their next pickup here. And the Zeus, he could also, with the Lion having so much control, I wouldn't really mind seeing a Zeus run in the support role here. And we have seen it quite a bit. There's a lot of utility you can gain from that. The Zeus can run up and hit the Death Ward, Witch Doctor. Also do a lot of damage to the Enchantress. I don't think you have to run the Zeus in the core role this time, but we'll see what Waterloo decide to go with for him. Honestly, with the Lion having so much control, you don't really need more of the same with the support. You can, and Zeus, that's one of his main weaknesses as a support. He just doesn't have that control. So we will be going in on the fourth pickup here, taking a lot of time thinking about their pick pretty hard. They do end up picking the Chaos Knight, and there's no Wisp in this lineup. This is going to make the All-Street Chain Hoop Ballers a little bit more tanky, able to survive through these fights a little bit more. One of the things about their team right now is they are pretty squish. They're fairly easy to take down with a big burst damage of Waterloo. They would probably be having a bit of a hard time in these fights.
Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
So we're going pretty deep into this reserve time right now. And right now, Waterloo, they still need a carry, and they may or may not need another support. And the All-Street Chain Hit Ballers, they probably haven't shown their mid yet. You could run the Lone Druid mid, but usually you don't see that. You could run the Enchantress mid. Not sure if they want to do that either. Especially if the Zeus were mid. I don't think that they... If they know that the Zeus is there, they would not put the Enchantress there as well. The Spectre would get picked up by Waterloo, and unfortunately it lost in the last match. And the Chaos Knight... early could do really well against a Spectre, as could a Lone Druid.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds.
So the Spectre might have a bit of a difficult match, but you also have this global lineup from Waterloo. You have the Zeus with the ultimate, as well as Spectre that could come in with the Haunt. That's a lot of burst damage that are going on to all of the heroes. Wow, CM seems really upset to be banned out of this match, as does the Death Prophet.
Radiant team pick.
Which will bring up us to our last picks, which is a Phoenix from the All-Street Chain Hoop Ballers. So this lineup is getting a little bit more form here. You are going to see something interesting in the mid lane. It's probably going to be an offlane Phoenix and a carry Chaos Knight. So we'll probably see Lone Druid mid. And I really like this against the Zeus. It really bullies him out of lane with the bear and makes it difficult for him to get that arc lightning off, and at least punishes him a lot for when he tries to do it.
10 seconds.
So this Lone Druid in the mid lane is going to be really interesting and fun to watch.
5 seconds remaining.
And of course the Phoenix doesn't really care too much about the burst damage that's coming out from Waterloo, and can disrupt the Spectre a little bit at the beginning of the game.
5 seconds remaining.
And finally, it is going to be the Earthshaker from Waterloo. Again, a lot of control. So we'll see the Zeus in the mid lane. The Earthshaker with the Fissure can interrupt the Death Ward pretty easily. You have a big Echo Slam that can possibly kill off the Phoenix before it goes into a dive or a supernova. And with that being said, we're going to be hopping into this best of one between the University of Waterloo and the All-Street Chain Hoop Ballers. And we'll be pretty excited for that. Once again, I'm Pythian, bringing this match to you off of Dota TV, as well as twitch.tv/PythianLegume. So we will be hopping right into this match, and we already have a disconnect right off the bat from the Chaos Knight. I guess that's part of his plan, right? We're probably going to have a pause. Yeah, we have the pause here. So Waterloo definitely have the big team fights and a lot of stuns. Basically all of their heroes except for one have a stun, and the All-Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they have the Witch Doctor and the Chaos Knight, which can be pretty good in the lane. And they also have a Lone Druid, which we will keep an eye on. I'm assuming he's going to go to the mid lane. The Phoenix, I'm thinking, might have a little bit of trouble in the offlane. You're going to have a Lion to deal with, as well as trying to stop a Spectre from getting farmed. The Spectre isn't really too much that you have to worry about. So we're going to get right into this match. And we have a 3-stack on the mid lane already. And they will smoke up. We may as well introduce our teams. We didn't do that just yet. So on the Witch Doctor, we've got Finger Telescope. Here on the Enchantress, it's going to be Husky. The Lone Druid will be handled by Sweatpants SC. And the Chaos Knight will be played by Sean Carter. And finally, Phoenix will be handled by Haz. Here for Waterloo, we've got Beastmaster on the offlane, played by Shakti. We may actually already have an engagement here. Scare Widow on the Beast, on the Earthshaker, actually already going to get absolutely wrecked here. And they're going to put the Reality Rift pretty aggressive onto the Zeus. They think they're going to get both here. So Sean Carter goes for that Reality Rift first. They're trying to chase on the Zeus, who's being played by Burnham. He's trying to run for his life right here. And Real Hobo is trying to help him out on the Spectre. Waterloo, Benguin with a nice stun by the Lion. And here comes the Bear. They're going to dive this one. And they have the clear better level one. The Bear blocks them out a little bit, and the Coconut comes through. Lone Druid will get the kill onto the Zeus, and while Finger Telescope will get taken down, Husky's taking a lot of damage from the tower. Gonna get blocked in by the Fissure, and this is gonna be two kills off the back of that. Are they gonna be able to get anything else? They could go for the Bear, who doesn't have a blink at this point, and gonna get smacked down by that dagger. Lone Druid gets slowed down a little bit. Zeus comes in from the back. And he's going to get fissured in the face. That's going to be another kill for Waterloo. As they take three off the back of that. So they get a lot off of the invasion by the All Street Chain Who Ballers. And I'm not sure who got the advantage there, but it was certainly an interesting fight, and definitely using the Lone Druid Bear to tank up a lot of that damage there. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough as Enchantress got caught up underneath the tower, and a Knife Fissure from Scare Widow secured the kill there. And the Zeus TPing in the backside of it also helped them out. So it is going to be a dual lane Enchantress and Phoenix in the top lane against the tri lane of the Earthshaker, Lion, and Spectre. Meanwhile, on the offlane, it is the Beastmaster against the Chaos Knight. And in the mid lane, as we talked about, it is Zeus versus the Lone Druid. And the Lone Druid has already taken quite a bit of damage. But I don't think he really minds. Oh, dive here onto Benguin. He's got a stun in 8 seconds. And they're putting the damage here. Lots of damage onto the Enchantress. Lots onto the Phoenix. And the Lion is backing up. They didn't have the Earthshaker there. If they did, they probably could have hit a good fissure onto that. But instead, they're going to be forced back. And Witch Doctor will also be helping out the Chaos Knight on the bottom lane. That could be a problematic lane. Oh man, cancel. And then a hit onto the Reality Rift. And they will easily take out the Beastmaster. That's what you got to worry about in this lane. If you're on low health like he was right there, you definitely have to be careful of the double stun coming out from the Radiant. Now there's going to be a dive onto Scare Widow. Scare Widow trying to get back. And he's taking a lot of damage. Fire Spirit will hit. And they could use the Troll Creep to go in. They're going to put another Spirit onto the Lion. And they may both get out here. Staying alive here. And the Troll Creep will get down by the tower. So it's not going to be taken out by the Earthshaker. They're just using that to tank up the tower a little bit there. And, well, both teams pretty evenly matched right now, but the All Street Chain Hoop Baller is being definitely a lot more aggressive in all of the lanes right now. Oh, wow. Sweatpants getting very low on the mid lane. He's going to force out a TP from the Witch Doctor, and the Witch Doctor TP actually gets canceled, and there's going to be a resummon on the Bear. Zeus just having a lot of that damage over time in the mid lane with the Arc Lightning, doing a lot of work there. And in terms of last hits, he's a little bit behind the Lone Druid who's currently leading, but he's not doing too terribly, and in terms of items, he does have the bottle up.
By Zeus.
Zeus is going to pick up an illusion there and use it in the mid lane to do some auto attack damage to the creeps. He's actually going to miss that one. And he will hit that last hit, so good there. And, well, look at this Witch Doctor being very aggressive. He's got the Beastmaster Boar. He's going to kill that off. And the little courier goes and gets the salve over to the Beastmaster. And he'll regen up and go back over to that bottom lane. The All-Street Chain Hoop Baller is being really aggressive here. Just really putting the pressure onto University of Waterloo here. And Finger Telescope is waiting at the rune spot. He's ready with the stun. The Beastmaster Hawk will come in. The stun is going to get used by the Witch Doctor, but now he's going to get chased down by the Zeus. There's also a boar here, ready with the slow, going to slow him down a little bit. Witch Doctor trying to regen up. And Zeus has another lightning bolt, but they're just going to disengage here. Wasn't going to get enough damage with it. And that leaves the Phoenix alone on the top lane. Phoenix is going to use the Fire Spirits, dive in onto the line. He's going to complete the dive, doesn't want to be too aggressive, and here comes the big laser. The Hadouken just misses onto the line. Maybe they would have been able to get close to the kill there if they had that, but I don't think they would have taken him down. The Phoenix will finish off the Tranquil Boots there. So we'll give him a little bit more survivability on the top lane. And actually, they are diving onto Real Hobo. Real Hobo with the dagger trying to get out, increases the move speed a little bit, goes into the trees, gonna come back. Gotta be careful of those creeps. There's gonna be another Hadouken available from the Satyr, and it's gonna throw it out, do quite a bit of damage to Real Hobo, who's going to continue back up. Line getting blocked up a bit by the creeps, gonna allow the Enchantress to get the slow. And Benguin, there's a nice fissure here by the Earthshaker, but the Hadouken will clear up the lion.
In your backside.
And look how far behind the tower they are. That's pretty ridiculous. Beastmaster has moved over to the jungle, has the Iron Talon, and we'll just clear up some of these creeps. And there is a Zeus ult that ends up killing the Phoenix in the top lane. Rip Bird. So the Zeus was able to secure one there. And in terms of... I think that was more of a mana thing, as he ran out of it to cast, and then he ended up being able to get it off. Enchantress right now has 1,400 gold, refreshes the enchant on the centaur.
Come get healed.
And there is a rotation onto the mid lane. Phoenix ready here to go up against the Invis Rune Birdum. So that's a bit unfortunate. He has the Invis Rune, so you're not able to go on him. But he could be aggressive here, and the Enchantress, the Phoenix still sticking around. I don't know why I thought that was Enchantress. And Birdum, why is he sitting there? He doesn't see the Phoenix. Wait, does he? I think he sees the Phoenix. Now he doesn't. Yeah, so he did have vision of the Phoenix there. And it's going to be a rotation by the Earthshaker. Hits a fissure, and they're getting a lot of damage. The coconut will bounce around. And the Lone Druid, he's still safe. Oh, the Entangle, but it doesn't matter. The Lone Druid does go down with that lightning bolt. And the killing spree goes to the Lone Druid in the end. Got a very lucky entangle right there. And they actually have a gold, positive gold change there. After that fight somehow. Enchantress went for the phase boots first. So she wants a little bit more damage, a little bit more move speed here. And Zeus is TP back to that mid lane. He has the ultimate available. He's also got that Arcana. We haven't really looked at that. We could have a courier snipe here by the Enchantress. She goes for one, goes for two. Are they even going to see it? They didn't have the speed boost, and the cargo is worth nothing, but the courier is worth everything. They take it down. It's so pretty and all, but it will be dead for 3 minutes now. Another lucky untangle onto the Zeus in the mid lane. Here's a dive in by the Phoenix. Uses the supernova, and this is going to be your Zeus going absolutely down to the all three chain hop ballers. I think that's her name. Nice fissure onto Husky, and she will get turned into a frog, but she's got the tomato working on Penguin, and the second in Pettis will take her out. Him out. And there's going to be the Enchantress continuing to do more work. She's got four levels up in the Untouchable. They are not going to hit that. And she uses a Fairy Fire. The Zeus ult not going to be enough. Are they going to go for more? It's going to be one hit. Are they going to be able to get it? There's a TP in. So the Enchantress gets out. The tower goes down to the lone druid. And there is also the Hand of Midas that's going to get picked up by him. Coconut going to get used onto the creeps, pushing him out a little bit, keeping the Witch Doctor safe from the Spectre. And, well, Chaos Knight goes right onto Penguin, gets a stun on him. He doesn't have a Hex, and Sean Carter just going to back up. The line was a bit too far away, and the drum usage there wasn't enough to be able to secure the kill. The Chaos Knight will hit these creeps. Gets a nice little crit right there. He's gone 4-3-1 on his build. And he... Did he just sell a mango? Don't sell mangoes. Eat them. He uses the Reality Rift, and look at that damage onto the lion. Absolutely kills him. And the lion was just trying to get a little bit of XP there on the bottom lane. He's currently at level 5. But unfortunately, in that pursuit, he ends up going down to the Chaos Knight, who right now is leading the last hits, and right now is 1-0-2. The Spectral comes through, and the Chaos Knight has TP'd out, so they weren't able to get to him in time. Urshager trying to rotate over to the top lane, doesn't have an Echo Slam just yet, and just look at all these creeps. So many units to push in that top tier 1 tower, and the Fissure doesn't quite hit all of them, so this will be an easy tower here for the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. Dyer's and Waterloo are trying to answer with something of their own on the bottom. They got the Spectre trying to go in. But that's going to be quickly cut short. And look at all these creeps here that the Dyer are going to try to finish up. But while that's happening, the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers are going to continue to push in top. And it's only the Earthshaker here to stop them. Not yet level 6. And he definitely doesn't have a Blink Dagger. It's going to be quite a while until he gets there. Chaos Knight Reality Rift on the Shakti on the bottom lane. He's going to use the drums to try to get away. He's getting slowed down by the boar. He's going to get slowed down by the dagger. The boar could go down in a little bit. And there's going to be another Reality Rift on the Shakti. Lots of damage. There goes the Coconut. Finger Telescope has taken a lot of damage on the backside of this. There's the Zeus ult. Doesn't quite take him down. And now Sean Carter, he's... did he actually get yelled at? He got yelled at by the Beastmaster, and he's going to end up dying there. So Waterloo are able to get the Chaos Knight as a result of this, and this is going to be a big gold change for Waterloo, even with the Earthshaker going down. Haste. The Spectre right now, Phase Boots and an Urn of Shadows coming in. But she might get ganked here. Here comes the Coconut and the Death Ward. The Phoenix has a Supernova available, but it's not even going to be needed as the Fire Spirits will tick out. And the Spectre goes down. Lion again on the mid lane. Gets hit by Impetus. Not having a good day with this Enchantress. There's going to be a Fissure. Only hits onto the Bear. And Shakti will also be here. He's got the Roar in 30 seconds. And Skerudo, he's near his base. He's going to use the Echo Slam to interrupt the Lone Druid's TP back to base. And Lone Druid is taking a lot of damage from this. Is the bear going to be able to do enough, though? The last Arc Lightning will finish up the Lone Druid, and the rest of the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they weren't anywhere close, and they will be pushing the bottom lane. So Waterloo getting back into this game a little bit. Zeus has 15 seconds left on the ultimate line. A little bit far in here. There's going to be a haunt. Nice double stun by the line. And the finger will finish off the Phoenix. Now Sean Carter eventually does go down. Are they going to be able to chase out this Witch Doctor? He's got the TP away, and he will make it out. But that's a couple of kills on the bottom lane and a big gold change for Waterloo, getting a big way back into this match. The Beastmaster pushes in the mid lane. And we may as well take a look at the net worth, as Azus is currently leading that. And he's doing rather well, 5-3-4 right now. So that's why you see him at the top.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Got a TP in by the Phoenix. You do see the Spectre here trying to farm out. There's going to be a TP in by the Chaos Knight as well. Doing some Fire Spirit damage is the Phoenix. The Phoenix has Supernova and won't be able to get it off once again. Lion takes a lot of damage. He got the stun, but the Impetus will once again finish off the Lion. This Enchantress is just the bane of Lion's existence right now. This will not going to come out from the Enchantress. The Earthshaker trying to look for a good fissure here. And there is going to be a nice fissure on the 4, but will the bear be able to get the root? He's going to go into the trees, trying to juke as much as he can, trying to TP out. The bear doesn't see him just yet, and wow, the Earthshaker somehow gets out. It's like a freaking Houdini. The Zeus has TP'd in. Oh my gosh, look at that ensnare onto the Spectre, and the coconut continues to bounce around. 3 bounces onto the Zeus. Not having a good day right now. Here comes the Lion. Actually hits a stun onto the Witch Doctor. Doesn't have the finger available. And the Witch Doctor does take a lot of damage from it, but the bear was just too scary. The bear is taking a lot of damage, but there's a Reality Rift to the other side of the fissure. Now here comes the Death Ward. Finger Telescope does get interrupted by the Hex, and the Zeus, he will end up taking out the bear. There's the Spectre Haunt getting used, and there's the Supernova. They're going to try to take it down. Shakti a little bit, he doesn't really make up his mind about it. Eventually, they do end up taking out the Phoenix, and they're trying to chase down this Lone Druid. He jukes to the north. Is he going to get out? Is he going to get denied? He's going to get stunned by and actually killed by the Spectre. So he gets stunned by the Lion, and he was trying to get that denied to the neutrals there. Wasn't quite able to get it off, and Waterloo was taking some big fights right here. We see 4 down right now for the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. And, well, this is not a lineup you want to look back into this match. They've got the Drum of Endurance finish on the Spectre. We'll see what the next item is going to be from her. But Waterloo coming back into this match in a big way. Just the All Street Chain Hoop Ball is balling a little bit too hard and trying to take too many of these fights, trying to go for towers a little bit hard. Shakti's going to go into the trees. He sees the Phoenix with the bird, and the TP... Oh, get canceled. Please cancel that TP. Thank you. And while the stun will hit onto the Phoenix has the Supernova down, using the last fight, and the finger in the back by Benguin takes him out. It's going to be another bear here from the Lone Druid and Waterloo. We'll see if they decide to back up. They're a little bit low on mana and health, and only the Zeus remains. Finger Telescope going to get stunned out by the Lion. The Veil of Discord going to get used, and the Mana Suck was there as well, and there's the Zeus Soul getting him out of there. Take that Witch Doctor down, and Waterloo, they're just going to back up a little bit here. They've got all 5, and they're going to do things elsewhere on the map. The Spectre TP's to top, getting a little bit more farm. And I love this Veil of Discord from the Zeus. It just does so much for your team. And with the Finger and the Echo Slam, you just have a lot of potential from that Veil to just absolutely wreck the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. Maybe you'll see Waterloo balling on the Ballers. So this game going pretty well. 12 kills to 16 if we take a look at the XP right now in favor of Waterloo after that not so good beginning for them. The Chaos Knight though does have the armlet, so things are going to get a little bit more difficult for Waterloo if the CK is on top of his armlet toggles. And this Lone Druid has 2600 gold, so he's definitely working on that Radiance, going to get there pretty quickly. Got the Phoenix firing the laser, takes out the Hawk. And right now, the Spectre looking pretty good in the jungle, farming up some creeps. 1800 gold right now. We'll see what the next item is. It'll be interesting to see if she decides to go for the counter Radiance or maybe a Diffusal Blade. We did see Blitz, who is unfortunately a Storm Spirit player as we see the Witch Doctor go down. We saw Blitz go for the Mantis Stout in the last matchup. But what does he know? He plays Storm Spirit. Of course, if you weren't here the last match, Vegetable Esports were able to get the win against... They lost. They lost against Colossus Gaming. And Colossus Gaming just very strong against an experienced Vegetable Esports squad. They knew how to get a lot of that out of the map, but the lineup for Colossus Esports just very... very good. They had an OD and Orsa. Those were the big characters. Also, the Beastmaster set up things pretty well for them. And they also had an Omni Knight solo lane against a Broodmother, which went pretty well for them. The Omni Knight had a great start, got Guardian Grease first. But back to this game. We've got a push by Waterloo onto the bottom tier 2 tower. The Spectre has Haunt available, and the Earthshaker right now trying to farm up that Blink Dagger, almost there. The Chaos Knight coming in from the side has that Reality Rift available. He's trying to get in range of the Zeus, who's only on Brown Boots right now. Lion just looking for the best stun here. And there's going to be a Reality Rift onto the Lion, uses the stun. And oh no, wow! He TP's out right before that Coconut comes through, and the Zeus gets out, only the Lion being the casualty here, as Beastmaster is going to TP over to the top lane. So Waterloo get the disengage right there. And they are going to be A-OK. Earthshaker has gotten a Blink Dagger, so it's going to be a really good Echo Slam. He's also pretty close to level 11. And he's going to get scouted out by the Bear, who chases him down a little bit. Beastmaster pushes in top. He's got the Necrobook too. And there will also be a push coming in mid from the Spectre.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower.
A couple of pushes on the towers. The bottom tower goes down to the Enchantress. The Spectre a little bit far in here uses a dagger to get out. We'll go to the north. But the top tower will also be taking a lot of damage from the Beastmaster. Eventually going to get the Fortify Forest. And meanwhile on the bottom we've got a Fissure coming out from the Earthshaker. Has that Echo Slam available. Anti uses it. Finger on the Phoenix. Stops the supernova from happening, and there's going to be a Haunt in from the Spectre. Goes on to Finger Telescope. There is a nice Savage Roar coming out from the Bear, which forces him back to the base. The top tower will get denied by the Enchantress, and that Coconut continues to bounce around. Look at it go. On the front side, Earthshaker trying to do some damage. He is not going to quite get that stun onto the Witch Doctor, and oh no, the Coconut bouncing around the Death Ward doing so much damage, and the Zeus, oh well, they may get the kill, almost gets the kill, and will now get it with the Arc Lightning. The dagger takes the Witch Doctor pretty well. Another Savage Roar by the Bear will force the Dire back here. Such a strong spell. And here comes the Phantasm and the Chaos Knight in from the side. They can definitely blow up a hero here. Will they find the Zeus? He's not got the illusions with him. He has a stun available. Will he be able to get it? Oh, not even going to be able to get the Reality Rift off. And the Zeus is able to TP back the base. Enchantress has the Dragonlance, is working towards the Aghanim Scepter, about 70 gold away from that. So she'll have it in basically that creep, and she'll immediately get it delivered out to her. The Beastmaster could rotate on her. He's got the Primal Roar available, and in terms of sight, they could see them coming around the trees here. They don't just yet. Yeah, he's right there. So they see him, and she knows to back out. The Spectre has 4,000 gold. I'm guessing this is going to be a Radiance from her then. And she'll go over near the secret shop, and I'm guessing going to pick up that relic. And indeed does pick it up. So this is going to be a Radiance Spectre. And she's going to continue to clear these creeps, trying to get that recipe purchased. The Lion also has a Blink Dagger. So you've got a lot of items coming out here from Waterloo, and there's also a Yule Scepter on the Zeus, so he's going to be a little bit more survivable through these fights. And the Necro 3 soon to be finished off by the Beastmaster. So a plethora of items. I said plethora. I said a word, guys. Anyway, Husky taking a lot of damage on the mid lane. Enchantress. Oh, they can't get finished off by the Earthshaker. Now here comes the Deathward Impetus. Does do a bit of damage, and now Hobo comes in from the side. Supernova gets used. They can't go in on that. They do end up taking the insurance, but for the Zeus and the Earthshaker. So not the best fight right there, and they also weren't able to get that Echo Slam off. I wonder why the Earthshaker didn't use it. Maybe he got stunned up, but it looked like he was trying to auto-attack the Enchantress for the kill. But the rest of the Radiant were just rushing in. Maybe the Echo Slam would have been the best thing to do there. Of course, I'm not sure about that, but definitely seems like it should have been used. Spectre in the mid lane, going to get stunned up and ensnared by the bear. Just burning him off with that bear's Radiance, which he did end up buying. There's going to be a double stun and the Reality Rift on the Penguin, taking a lot of damage, but he's going to be stopped by the Primal Roar of the Beastmaster. He's out of mana now. And the Echo Slam comes through. There's the dunk and the double kill by the Earthshaker. The Savage Roar is going to get used. Oh, Penguin, he's going to be so aggressive for his team. He's going to take the fall here. And are they going to be able to get anything off of it? The Blink is going to continue to be canceled by the Bear. He will have it now. Impetus comes in from the side. We'll finish off the Beastmaster, but Earthshaker with a finish. Fissure to the finish of the Lone Druid. Now the Earthshaker comes in, gonna take a lot of damage from the Impetus, ends up going down to the Enchantress with that Dragon Lance and the Aghanim Scepter, doing a lot of damage there. And Zeus unable to do anything else off of that. He's getting the Yule Scepter delivered to him right now, and that is a pretty even fight. A little bit of an advantage going to Waterloo, as they ended up taking down the Lone Druid and the Chaos Knight, which are pretty high CS characters. The Lone Druid actually topping the board right now. And the Spectre has the Radiance in the inventory, and we'll be getting it on the courier right now. Nineteen kills to 23, the Radiance against Radiance of the Spectre and Lone Druid. Meanwhile, the Enchantress, she's starting to be a little bit scary right now, has a casual cloak to help against the Zeus, which is really the main source of damage against her. And she's got 1,400 health, so you could see this Enchantress starting to be a bit more of a problem in this game. The Witch Doctor has gone for a Glimmer Cape, going to help him in these fights a little bit more. And the Phoenix also has a Hood of Defiance, which is really one of the main problems of the Dire Squad. Meanwhile, as we say that, Finger Telescope gets just wrecked by heaven, as Zeus comes in with the Roar of the Beastmaster and just absolutely obliterates the Witch Doctor. Spectre has that Radiance in her inventory now. It's going to push in through top, has that Haunt available to come in, and we'll make it level 3. So it's going to be a level 3 Haunt, and the Finger comes in. Oh, Husky taking a lot of damage from the Radiance, and now they have the Supernova very far ahead. They can easily take this out. Spectre will Haunt in to get that Phoenix, and they will get 2 kills off of that. Double kill for the Spectre. Now they will push in through bot. They also have that Echo Slam available of the Earthshaker. He's also got 2,400 gold in the inventory. Buyback on the Enchantress. Radiance bottom tower. And they're going to be even further behind on gold after that. Bear has a Savage Roar available. He'll be taking a lot of damage, though. And the next Zeus ult is in about 30 seconds. If the Radiant group up here, they can easily get hit by the Echo Slam. And it looks like the Waterloo boys are just going to go for a smoke, and I think it's a fake back, or no, they're just going to go for Roshan. It was either a fake back there, or it was a Roshan, and they're just going to go for the Rosh. Or not. It's a fake back. They're going to go for the mid lane. They still have 2 towers up there. Here comes a bear. They're not going to do anything about it just yet, but there's the Enchanter. She's going to break the smoke, and the bear's in the middle of all of them. There's going to be a yell on the Finger Telescope. They don't have detection for him just yet, but Real Hobo will be burning him off. Penguin takes a lot of damage from the bear, and another smoke away, but Lion's still going to be in vision. Takes an impet, actually blinks away. He's going to avoid the Impetus. The Spectre TPs out. Earthshaker gets a fissure off onto the bear, and we've got a queen breakaway by Waterloo. They're going to get everyone out, although we could see the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers go for the Roshan. They end up getting the D ward by Finger Telescope, which effectively takes away almost all the vision except for the Hawk for Waterloo. They don't have any wards on the map right now. Well, now they just put one down near the Rosh pit. And they also have the Hawk there, giving a little bit more vision. Now the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they're grouping up near the bottom lane, and they will defend mid as Shakti gonna get screwed over by the Chaos Knight. The mid tower did take a lot of damage, and the Necrocreeps continue to go for it. The Enchantress steals a Necrocreep, and it will push in on the mid lane. The Coconut gonna bounce around. So we've got 28 minutes on this matchup, looking pretty good right now. And the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they're gonna go into the Roche Pit. Chaos Knight has finished off the Sanj and Yasha. And we'll see if Waterloo are able to do anything about this. They have an Echo Slam available on the Earthshaker. We've seen some big plays by him, but he's gonna get canceled out by the Enchantress. And the Enchantress just being so aggressive with the Impetus. There's the Spectre Haunt gonna get used. And the Finger will finish off the Enchantress. And that could force the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers out of this one. And it could be an easy Roche for Waterloo. Got the Radiant smoked up here. Looking for the pickoff. Gonna get broken by the Spectre. Spectre could get caught out, getting Radiance down by the Bear, but she's doing Radiance of her own. Nice Vision is going to interrupt the laser of the Phoenix, and there's gonna be a Death Ward doing a little bit of damage here, but it's so broken up. The Phoenix comes in with the Supernova, and Waterloo are just forced back. They've got the Lion going down. Now Spectre could get caught out. On the other side, we've got the Earthshaker trying to get away, but he's going to get hit by those Fire Spirits, and he will end up going down to the Urn of Shadows. The rest of Waterloo trying to get out, getting chased down by a CK Illusion, but they're going to be just fine. And it's a 2-for-1. With a lot of gold going to the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. And there they go, back into the Roche Pit. They're quickly taking this Roshan down. And the Spectre, what is she getting delivered to her right now? She's got the Yasha. But I'm guessing it's going to be a Manta style for her. Beastmaster is teleported over to the top lane. He's going to get slowed down by the Enchantress. There goes the Impetus, and he's popped his Necro 3 to try to ward her off.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Waterloo, they've done a lot of work on the bottom lane, but they do need to do some elsewhere. They have two towers up in the mid lane, as well as one top. So Beastmaster kind of feels that, trying to do as much work as he can. He's got the Boots of Travel and the Necro 3, just trying to do all that he can to try to put some more pressure on the map and get some more map control. The tier 1 tower gets denied by the Phoenix, and Shakti was trying to look for something with that Necro book, but he's not going to find it and just goes over to the mid lane to farm some creeps. Spectre with her Radiance is sending the courier over to the secret shop to build up that ultimate orb, which will finish off the Manta style. Right now, this Spectre getting very farmed. And the question is, at what point does it become too much difficulty for the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers to fight against her? So there's the Manta style going to get finished. They don't have a Lion in this case that was used in the last match to just get rid of the illusion. So the Manta style is pretty good. And they could push in through mid. The Aegis is on the Lone Druid right now, which may or may not be the best hero if he uses the resummon before or after the Aegis. Still goes down pretty quickly in a lot of cases. If you can focus down a Lone Druid, it's pretty easy to take him down both times. And the Chaos Knight looks to be going for a BKB. Got the Bear pushing in top. Also has a Maelstrom. And Earthshaker being really aggressive, trying to look for an opening here onto the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He will find a Bounty Rune and will back up. He's got the Blink and Force Staff. The Bear will be able to blink out. Gonna get away from the Waterloo boys here. Zeus just faking the ultimate here. And it looks like he's going for an Octarine Core, I believe. Could also be a Bloodstone. Zeusul gonna get used to scout here, does a lot of damage, and it's gonna force out the Pipe of Insight from the Phoenix. Been taking a look at the Enchantress. She's still on her casual cloak. And Earthshaker will hang out here on the top, on the high ground here. And we'll put a Fissure out on those illusions. Gonna be a Coconut coming out from the Wish Doctor. And Earthshaker will just finish off those illusions at the high ground there. The Phoenix dive comes in from the Phoenix. Makes sense, right? It's actually an Icarus dive. It's not a Phoenix dive. And Waterloo, for some reason, hanging again back on the bottom lane. There's no outer towers for them to take there, so they're just going to push it in. And the All-Street Chain Hoop Bar has set their sights on top. I'm going to try to go for a tier 2 there. Spectre pushes pretty quickly, but so does the Bear with the Radiance of the Lone Druid. So we'll see who's able to get there first. Maybe it's not even going to be a race. The rest of Waterloo, that looks like they're gathering around a mid. So they've got three bottom, two mid. And they are forcing back the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers a little bit. Again, this is a matchup in the round of 64 of the BTS America Series Open Qualifier. And I'm Pythian, casting this match for you off of Dota TV as well as on twitch.tv/PythianLagoon. So at 34 minutes into this match, we've got a fairly even match if we look at the XP, only about 7,500 in favor of Waterloo, and you know, net worth is pretty even right now. We've got some scouting going on. The Earthshaker going to force staff away from the Witch Doctor. The Witch Doctor just kind of looks around for a second, tries to see if there's an observer ward there. There isn't. And he places down one of his own. CK finishes off his BKB, and there's also a Vlad's on the Beastmaster. Enchantress finally finishes off that Glimmer Cape. It took her a while to do so. And where's the Bear? There we go. Oh wow, there's already a BKB used by the Chaos Knight. Okay. I don't really think they needed it for the fight. But to avoid that lion might be a good thing. So I think they can still fight here, but it might just make them feel like they can't, especially with that BKB being down.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Right now, Waterloo just trying to keep the lanes pushed out. We've got the lion just running around here. It's got a point booster, so I'm guessing this is going to be an Aghanim Scepter. It's the build that I used to go when I first played Lion. These are very sad days and very, very long ago. Still play Lion sometimes. Funny story about him. One time, my friend decided to give me an item for Lion with a gem on it. The gem was for... Okay, we've got a Haunt in by the Spectre. I guess you can learn about that later. Glimmer Cape gonna get used by... the Finger Telescope, and he will end up going down to a massive damage getting used by the Spectre. The Fusion Blade doing a lot of work here. Real Hobo, though, taking a lot of damage, will end up going down, and with that Haunt being down, there's no reason to buy back there. Two will go down, that's the Beastmaster, and well, the Earthshaker. He's gonna force staff out of the range of that Supernova, but he's gonna continue to get hit by that laser. The Phoenix comes in, and the Impetus will be doing a lot of damage, and eventually takes down the Beastmaster. So that's gonna be 3-for-1. 3-for-a-support for Waterloo. That's not the best fight you want to go for. And I guess they were feeling kind of aimless there and really wanted to do something on the map. Unfortunately, that just didn't work out for them. And they're going to lose 3 there and delay the game a little bit more. Yeah, the Spectre was right there. And we see a push here from the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers going down mid. You do have 2 buybacks available on the Earthshaker and the Spectre. Earthshaker once again did not use the Echo Slam, so he will have it for this defense in 20 seconds. We'll see if the All-Street Chain Hoop Ballers are able to push faster than that. The Bear does do quite a bit of damage. There's a Pipe of Insight getting used. It's going to make the Zeus not very effective at all. Hardly doing any damage to those creeps. Better off auto-attacking those Zeus. And that's half damage on the tower before it gets fortified. So here comes the push. The Earthshaker has respawned. The Spectre will be here soon as well. 25 seconds still on the sideline, or on the Haunt cooldown. Mia Laser getting fired by the Phoenix to heal up the bear a little bit. So back on my Lion story. So my friend gave me an item with a gem on it that was for First Bloods, and he said, hey, I bet you're never gonna fill this up. In fact, that's the dedication on it. It's like, you will never get this. So then I play one match as Lion. For some reason I went mid. Oh no, they kill an Enchantress Illusion. And they know that they're there. Well, that's unlucky. A bit unfortunate. So he says that I will never get a First Blood on it. So then the first match, for some reason, I go mid as Lion. I'm against a Queen of Pain. She tries to go against me level 2. I just hex her and do a lot of damage with auto attacks, and then I spike her, and then she ends up dying. So in my first match with that item on, I get a freaking kill. So then right away, I'm like, yo, I got it on your item. His reaction was unrewarding, to say the least. But still, it's kind of funny. I see a push here by the All Street Chain, who bars onto the bottom lane. Blink forward by the Lion. He's not going to be able to get anything onto the Phoenix before the Icarus dive comes through. Beastmaster continuing to be antisocial and push towers apart from his team. And that will force the All Street Chain ballers back. And maybe Waterloo can get something off the back of this. They have a nice ward here. Did see where the Witch Doctor was. But they were a little bit too far to be able to engage on him. And Lion's getting deep here, trying to get that nice ward down. And he will. Tough game right now, 40 minutes in. And it doesn't really look to be going either way right now. Things are fairly even. The Roshan has respawned. Lion blinks right in there, only to get smacked down by the man himself. And look, he's already half health. Look, you don't want to solo a Roshan as Lion. It's a very difficult thing to do. And there's going to be a Reality Rift onto the line. He uses the Yule Scepter to try to get away. And he's going to get hit by that stun and absolutely wrecked by those illusions. And now the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they have the Phantasm here. And, wow, look at all these creeps. I don't know how they got there. It's probably because of the bear. And they will push in through mid. They've got the Zeus down. He has buyback. See if he decides to use it. They also have a big Echo Slam and Spectre combo. There's a blink forward, not going to be into the middle of them. I guess he wasn't ready to go for the Echo Slam combo just yet. He's going to get scared out by the bird. Impetus comes through the side. He's taking a lot of damage from that. Another blink in a couple of seconds. They need to be careful. They're only sending the Phantasms up for this, and the bear with the Phantasms just do so much damage to the tower. Penguin takes about half health from that one Impetus. There's another one, and this third one will take him down. Just 3 hits from the Enchantress, and they take out the racks. Meanwhile, on the top lane, we've got Phoenix going after the Spectre. Spectre not going to be doing any damage with those illusions, so the Spectre does get out of that one. And they will not find the Spectre there. We could see them go for another tower. The bottom lane is pushing in, so they're going to send back the Enchantress to take care of that. And Spectre has the highest net worth, but it's not seeming too effective right now. What they really need is a big Echo Slam by the Earthshaker. They need to have him just come through on that. And we're still waiting. We're still waiting to see that. The Waterloo boys have gone into the Roshan pit. And they're taking it down fairly quickly. Roshan doesn't like the slams the ground in fury, but they are going to get out. The Earthshaker immediately TP's over to the top lane to defend that from the bear. And they've got a nice advantage for their Spectre now. They've got the Aegis, and they still have buyback. That's 5,300 gold. I think she's waiting to maybe get enough for another item slot. She actually does buy something. What does she buy? She buys a quarterstaff. It's going to be a butterfly from the Spectre. Butterfly from Butterfly Spectre. And Waterloo are going to push through mid. This is the Well, one of the two remaining outer towers. Spectre has the butterfly, and she also has a Haunt and an Aegis. So I would say you just push her in through that mid lane and see what the other team can do. They may want to clear out top first. Oh, Beastmaster Bounty Rune sounds. It's the clowniest thing in the game. So Zeus and the Lion will push out through top. And right now, this Zeus's items, he's still working towards something to build with that Soul Booster. He did pick up an Aether Lens, though. Like that item. Bear's got an AC. There's also a Shiva's on the Phoenix. And wow, this Enchantress has a BKB. She's going to be near impossible to kill right now when that BKB is up. And well, it's going to be very difficult for Waterloo to try to take her down. They're going to go for mid. They smoke up. Radiance and tower. Beastmaster goes under a tower, which I guess reveals it. You generally don't see towers remove the smoke, but that one does. And the finger goes out onto Hawes, who gets absolutely blown up. Doesn't have buyback right now. Spectre just doing so much work on the backside with the illusions and going all over the place. So the supernova does go through. They have to take care of this Chaos Knight. Lion uses the Ghost Scepter to try to get away, and he does. The Spectre could get the Aegis pop. The Lion goes down, and they've got a lot of damage. Zeus is going to Yule Scepter himself up. He's got to get these illusions cleared out. There's going to be an Echo Slam by the Earthshaker, taking out the Chaos Knight. He's got buyback, and he may need to use it. The Bear is going to get smacked down by the Spectre, and that was a mega kill streak going to her as well. He's going to buy back, but he doesn't have Phantom this time. And this Bear, he's not got a... he just used a Resummon, I believe, or it's not there. It may not be there. That may have been a resummoned bear that just died. If so, that's a disaster. We're going to see a counter-raxing going on by Waterloo. They're going to quickly take down the ranged Rex, especially with the Beastmaster R. Phoenix is going to dive in, and there's going to be a nice long Chaos Bolt onto Real Hobo. And I think they're going to try to get out. She's taking a lot of damage here, and with the Aegis being gone, they're just going to back up. She's got 3,500 gold, and a lot. That's a lot of gold. I wonder what little boys would do with that kind of gold. Sorry if that's creepy. It wasn't really meant to be. If we take a look at the XP right here, and we can look at the gold swing as well, it's definitely going back in favor of Waterloo. Still pretty even, but looking pretty good right now. They did end up taking the ranged Rex. Weren't able to get the melee. So the lane from the Radiant will still push in. But less so. With those super Radiant... super ranged creeps that are going in. Super creeps. Now, 1999 with processing and handling. Wow, lots of wards going down here. You've got... Witch Doctor emptying out his stocks of the wards right there, putting them basically all nearly on top of each other. Maybe his team was spamming, "We need wards," in which case I would do that too. I would just put them wherever I am, because obviously we need them very quickly. Only one outer tower remaining for Waterloo to take down. Meanwhile, they have two of their own that are still up. The push will come in through top. And this all-street chain hoop baller squad, they take down towers really quickly. Enchantress has that centaur stomping on top of the Spectre right there. And there's a big creep wave coming in bot. It's not the biggest that I've seen, but still fairly large. The reality rift that gets used onto a boar. And there's going to be a yell going on to Sean Carter. It's a nice glimmer cape by the Finger Telescope, and he'll go down right immediately. And wow, that's an Echo Slam. A lot of hate for Chaos Knight, and without a buyback, this is going to be the All-Street Chain who bars on the back, but they need to make sure that the Enchantress can do her job here. She's got the Pipe of Insight. It's going to expire in a bit. Dive in by the Phoenix, and well, this Supernova could allow the Enchantress to output some damage. The stun not going to go on to anybody, and Shakti, he's up here. He wants to do something. He has a Refresher Orb getting bought. Right now, he's about 700 gold away from that. Nice fissure onto the Enchantress. She uses the BKB. She's going to do everything here. Spectre, about to die, doesn't have a Haunt, and does have buyback. Penguin just going to try to back up. uses the Ghost Scepter to get away so he doesn't get attacked by the Enchantress, and he is going to get out. So it's only the Spectre going down, but only the Spectre. That's a pretty big kill. Even so, they end up getting another ranged Rax. This is similar to a game we saw before. They took down all of the ranged Rax, but none of the melee. It was very difficult for them to push, and while Benguin continues to get chased down by a bear, oh no, he's got a magic wand available. Is he going to be able to use it? Use the wand, bro! What? You have a wand! Use the wand. I don't understand. Of course, it's very difficult to do that in the moment. Although, I think if I had a wand for about 45 minutes, I would probably use it. Especially when we get to 48. I'm pretty aware of what I can do, especially when I have that much time to think about it. It is difficult to do things in the moment, but I think that's something he definitely could have avoided. In any case, the lion goes down. And the CK is going for an MKB. That's definitely to go against the Spectre's butterfly. And the lone druid has a glimmer cape on himself, and the bear has an MKB as well. So he's got a lot of gold invested into the bear. We'll see if it works out. And there's also the beastmaster finishing up the refresher. He won't have buyback for quite a bit, but he has farmed up pretty well. He's fifth on the net worth chart, which is a little bit difficult to do as a beastmaster. And the Spectre also has 5,000 gold in the bank. You know, just a tiny sum. The usual. Enchantress continues to farm up. She's got 2,300 gold. If we look at the buybacks right now, Chaos Knight, his is still down for about a minute and 40. And Witch Doctor and the Lone Druid don't have it up either. The Beastmaster did buy back and is now down for another minute. And everyone else in the Dire has it. So they're going to smoke up here. The Phoenix is firing out the laser. They're going to go right past the Creep Wave. Shakti, he's going to get the smoke broken. The Fissure actually misses on everything. And the Echo Slam will hit on a couple. The Phoenix ball right there. Are they going to be able to take it down in time? They're going for it. Oh, there's a nice Savage Roar. It's going to make sure that three get hit by it. They've taken a lot of damage from this. And now Scarewood is trying to get out. Penguin will go down. And now it's just Spectre left all alone. Well, she's actually on the backside of this. Birdum trying to back up. There's going to be a nice totem. It's going to end up killing the Lone Druid. And the Enchantress. 1, 2, 3. Enchantress gets a triple kill, fulfilling and getting that full five-man team wipe. This is just how dangerous this Enchantress can be in a fight. If you're all low and you're all trying to back out, they just took so much damage there from the Lone Druid Bear and the Phoenix Supernova that they were all so low, and that ended up taking them out in that team fight. So Waterloo unfortunately give up a big fight there, and the creeps are pushing in top. They don't have any boots of travel right now, so it's not going to be a whole lot of damage going to that tier 3 tower. But that's pretty strong from the All Street Chain Hoop ballers, and Enchantress just balling all over the place. So she will push in through mid. It's only the Lion respawning right now. He's still got that point booster and also a Ghost Scepter. It's difficult for him to get that farm up. The Aghanim Scepter will definitely help him do damage against this Enchantress, which, as shown in the last fight, if you don't take care of her, she is going to be a problem. TP in by the Earthshaker, there's going to be a Fissure, and a 4-step forward underneath the tower. The Enchant Totem, it takes a while to hit, but here she comes. There's the BKB. Benguin has a Ghost Scepter for a little bit, but it's going to get taken off. There's the Paralyzing Cast, gets hit on two, and will scare Wado. He's got the Blink available. There's a Fissure, hits onto the Glimmer Caped Witch Doctor, and he'll go to the north. I'm not sure if they know about it. They don't see him, and he will just get out. So the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, they get a little bit of tower to the tier 3, a little bit of damage to the tier 3, and they end up getting out. Looking pretty good in this match, but you get the feeling that once Waterloo take down that tier 2 tower at top, if they get into the base and they win a team fight, they're going to pretty much end the game. So here come the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. They're smoked up, going for the Zeus. Zeus, he uses the Ghost Scepter, trying to get out. And there's the Spectral coming through. The Phantasm doing a lot of damage to the Zeus. And there's a nice Echo Slam. Does quite a bit of damage to the Radiant, but is it enough? You still have Sean Carter. He used the BKB. Didn't really take a whole lot from that, so it clears out the Phantasms, but that's about it. You've got three heroes with buybacks all down on Waterloo. And... well, here comes the push on the mid, and will they just try to end the game? Buyback on the Earthshaker, buyback on the Spectre, buyback on the Zeus. They all bought back, and, well, you got to think that the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers are just going to back up. There's a Roar onto the Phoenix. They have another one available. Roar onto the Lone Druid. Are they going to be able to take him down? They do a lot of damage with the Zeus, and the Baird goes down as well. There is the Phoenix trying to back up. Doesn't now has the dive, not going to be able to use it, and there's the Gem of Truce on the ground. Gem down. Earthshaker picks it up. And now Waterloo, they may try to push in through mid. You got buyback still on your Phoenix and Lone Druid. And here come Waterloo down the mid lane. Looks like they want to make something out of it. They want to finish off the melee racks mid and bot. The Roshan is also available, so they can maybe quickly take these out if there's no buybacks and then get out. So here they come. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And do they want to save their racks? It's going to be a fortify. No buybacks just yet. There are the buybacks now. They're getting in pretty far, and they're split up. This could be a big opportunity for the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers, as Waterloo, they're so far in, and with all their buybacks down, they do end up taking the racks, but with all their buybacks down, we got Zeus. He's right underneath the Death Ward. He's getting hit a lot. He's got no buyback. He's down for 100 seconds. Yeah, you need to be careful now. You need to get out. Gotta make sure you live to fight another. You did take out the mid racks, which basically evens out the equilibrium, and the creeps have pushed in through top.
Radiant's top tower.
Well, the Waterloo boys are near the Roshan pit, and we may see just another push in by the All Street Chain Hoop Ballers. It's gotten to that point of the game where they just want to push in and maybe end the game. So here they go in through mid. But look, you already have the Beastmaster on bottom, just taking out that tier, that bottom set of racks. They want to go for the tier 4. The tier 4s, they're going to go right for it. They have a lot of damage there. It's going to be a fortify being used. There's the Spectral. She's going to haunt in. And there's an Echo Slam onto the Chaos Knight. He didn't BKB this time. He's turned into a frog. He's taking a lot of damage from this. And this Supernova is doing a lot of work here. Spectre is going to get stunned. She has the Aegis. She will go down for the first time. She does not have a buyback. It's on cooldown for another 4 minutes and 30 seconds. This Chaos Knight does go down to the Finger of the Lion. And now they may take on that Lone Druid Bear. Beastmaster goes down. He has a buyback available. Enchantress, you gotta take care of her. She doesn't have the BKB. She's getting the mana sucked out of her. She doesn't have enough for the Impetus now. Phoenix trying to get out. We got a four staff forward by the Earthshaker. He's trying to chase down this Enchantress. He knows how much of a problem she is. And she is in the trees. She's getting burned down. I think they know exactly where she is. They are going to find her. And she's trying to get out. And there's another set of axes coming out from the Beastmaster. And, well, All Three Chain Hoop Ballers, they get a little bit far in here. They have buybacks on the Enchantress and the Chaos Knight. Somehow those were the heroes that didn't use them in the last fight, and they also used the buyback on the Witch Doctor. So a 3,700 gold change here in favor of Waterloo, and here comes the push right back. Earthshaker's just hanging out in the Roche pit a little bit. He's picking up, finding some gems. And once again, the Enchantress buys back. The only set of racks remaining are in the top lane because Beastmaster cleared them out, bot, before that fight happened. And there's going to be a roar onto the All Street Chain Hoop Baller Husky. There's going to be another roar onto the Enchantress. Just so much hate for her. They got to take her out. Finger will. And while the Death Ward still does some work, the Spectre going to go for the racks. Has the BKB used. And there's going to be a BKB by the Chaos Knight. Gotta be careful. He has a Phantasm in 15 seconds, doing quite a bit of damage to the Spectre, who doesn't have buyback. This is a big problem. You're working with a lot of buybacks here. The Echo Slam comes through by the Earthshaker. Lots of damage going onto the Chaos Knight, and Chaos Knight is down with no buyback. Spectre haunts in onto the Witch Doctor. Lone Druid trying to do some damage here, but it's just a bear, and he's got no little summon bear to help him out. Spectre will eventually go down. Earthshaker takes out the Phoenix, and they may try to go for the tower here. A Lone Druid in behind this. They see him. He will end up going down to the Spectre Illusion that's still here. And, well, that's going to be the Mega Creeps. Waterloo have taken Mega Creeps in this 58-minute game. Looking pretty good right here. And they're going to go in for the Tier 4s. No buybacks available for the Austria Chain Hoop Bars. And this is looking like it's it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Yep. Waterloo go in for the Tier 4s. Earthshaker's rather low. They're going to go for the... they're going to sit at the fountain. And, well, Zeus has picked up a Desolator. Desolator, Zeus, you got to get through these towers. You have 30 seconds on a respawn for the All-Street Chain Hoop Bars. And that's it. GG. That's it. That's all she wrote. And Waterloo are going to move into the round of 32, which is further than Vegetable Esports got in the BTS Series America's Open Qualifier. So Waterloo with a close game, 59 minutes, ended up coming on top of that one. And that's going to do it for this match. Once again, thanks for watching as always. Cheers. And I will be coming back on the stream in a little bit with some CSL Dota 2 action. We've got Pit against whoever they're playing. And I got a couple friends on that team. So I'm going to be casting it on the twitch.tv/PithianLegoom. So you can go over and watch that if you want to see some more Dota 2 action. Cheers. Okay, so I have 5 minutes.